We reported a story on heroin last week and the arguments for legalizing it. Now, from your letters and messages, it's clear why politicians find that option too hot to handle. On legalization, people are either for or against passionately.
It's unnatural that your children die before you.
And who would you blame?
Ignorance. Stupidity of people not to see facts.
Our story focused on Bridget Swartz and her heroin-addicted daughters and the Australian trial of legalised heroin now being denied them, a trial that treats the results of addiction rather than addiction itself. Overseas, that's yielding impressive results.
I don't think many people know how many young people have died, that 500 young people have died in the past 12 months. And I tell people that, and that shocks them.
Is the delay going to cost more lives?
Yes. People have already died since they said no to the heroin trial.
Don't blame the politicians for the deaths of drug takers. They put the needles in their arms. It's not the drugs that kill, it's the stupidity of the people themselves. And this? What next? Free wine for all alcoholics? A free TAB account for gamblers? There's only one thing to make them stop. It's called willpower. Or even better, won't power. But I lost my beautiful daughter to a heroin overdose this year. She was 28, with two wonderful sons. For 14 years, we tried to help her, but the dealers always hounded her back into addiction. Legalizing heroin is the only solution. Then the vultures who push drugs cannot profit from their terrible trade. Then there was our story on the surprising fate of the beautiful and now rare old hardwoods of North America, felled last century, floated to sawmills, but which sank waterlogged in the log jams along the way.
Every time you open up one of these logs, there's a wonderful surprise. It's the kind of timber that inspires craftsmen to create.
There it is.
There it is.
Right there.
And the treasure chest opens up.
What a refreshing story. No drama, no politics, no crime, no controversy. Just a story about nice people and beautiful timber. Thank you. And that's your say and our program for tonight. We'll be back with another edition of 60 Minutes next week. I'm Richard Carlton. See you then.
Before you scoot off, that edition of 60 Minutes was proudly brought to you by Toyota. Ow, ow.